Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover Bajaj Steel Salt Paper Management Trainee 2017. Paper already cancelled. Technical part I will cover from question number 114 onwards. Question is, a cylinder contains 5 meter cube of ideal gas at a pressure of 1 bar. This gas is compressed in a reversible isothermal process till its pressure increases to 5 bar. The work in kilojoule required for this process is how much? Isothermal compression process. Data given. Initial volume V1 is 5 meter cube and pressure P1 is 1 bar. Isothermal compression. P2 is pressure. Final pressure. P2 is 5 bar. So P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. As it's a isothermal process. N value is 1. So from here V2 we can calculate 1 into 5 divided by 5. So 1 meter cube. Then Wardon formula for isothermal process P1 V1 ln V2 by V1. So P1 is 1, V1 5 into ln V2 is 1 by 5. Compression process, so minus will come. Ignore that sign. Here some values you have to remember, standard values ln2, ln3, ln4 and ln5. These values if you remember then you can solve these questions, otherwise this type of questions you can't solve. ln1 is 0, ln2 so many times asked, so this is very important. ln2 value, ln3 is 1.09. ln4 1.38, ln5 is 1.6. So ln 1 by 5 means minus 1.6. Only minus will come here. So 5 into minus 1.6 you will get. This is in bar. So you have to, for kilojoule you have to multiply 10 to the power 3. If you multiply 10 to the power 3, sorry, you have to multiply 100, 500 into 1.6, already compression, so this is in terms of kilojoule, you will get 804.7, so A is the answer. In order to have maximum power from a Pelton turbine, the bucket speed must be how much? Bucket speed is small u, capital V is jet speed. So, for maximum power, u should be V by 2. Very important for all exams. Equal to half the jet speed. B is the answer. The shear stress strain graph for a Newtonian fluid is, for Newtonian fluid, the shear stress versus du by dy. So here Newtonian fluid, it will go like this. N equal to 1. And for dilatant, N is greater than 1 and for pseudoplastic N is less than 1. This is Newtonian fluid, straight line. So answer A. Here dilatant, pseudoplastic. Here Newtonian. Sometimes N value also they are asking. So for dilatant, n is greater than 1, and for pseudoplastic, n is less than 1, and n equal to 1 for Newtonian fluid, straight line. The flow in a pipe is turbulent when Reynolds number is a less than 2000, b between 2000 and 2800, c more than 2800, d none of these. C is the answer for turbulent flow. And for laminar flow, it should be less than 2000. This is also important. This is in between laminar flow and turbulent flow. In a steady flow process, the ratio of heat transfer is constant, B work transfer is constant, C mass flow at inlet and outlet is same, D all of these. All of these the answer. A series of operations which takes place in a certain order and restore the initial conditions at the end. Restore the initial conditions at the end. So, A reversible cycle, B irreversible cycle, C thermodynamic cycle, C is the answer. Carnot cycle, sometimes graph also they are asking. Both PV and TS diagram I will draw. PV and here TS. PV diagram. Two isothermal lines, T1, T2, then two isentropic lines. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, One, two, three, four. In TS diagram, here 3, 4 isothermal heat addition, heat supplied, here heat rejected, 1, 2, 2. Heat rejected, heat supplied. So, two isothermals and two isentropic process, B is the answer. Carnot cycle has maximum efficiency for A. Petrol engine, B. Diesel engine, C. Reversible engine. For reversible engine, Carnot cycle has maximum efficiency. C. Question is, one reversible heat engine operates between 1600 Kelvin and T2 Kelvin, and another reversible heat engine operates between T2 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin. If both the engines have the same heat input and output, then temperature T2 is equal to how much? This one already solved so many times. In ISRO also they are asking this type of exam, this type of questions. Other exam also they are asking. Directly also you can solve this question. 1600 into 400 root over, you will get your answer. So here, for fast heat engine, Q1 is the heat supplied, Q2 is the heat rejected. For second heat engine, E2, Q3 heat supplied, Q4 heat rejected. Here, this is the temperature T2. So, data given, Q1 heat supplied is same for both cases. And heat rejected also same, Q2 equal to Q4. So, for efficiency, fast engine, efficiency is Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Reversible heat engine, so T1 minus T2 by T1. And for second heat engine, its value is Q3 is the heat supplied, Q4 is the heat rejected divided by heat supplied. Q3. Reversible, so T3 minus T4, it's T2, sorry, it's T2 minus T3, T3 divided by T2. According to data, Q3 equal to Q1 minus Q4 is Q2 divided by Q1 equal to T2 minus T3 value is 400 divided by T2. So here we already get from equation 1, T1 minus T2 divided by T1 equal to T2 minus T3 by T2. If you solve this one, you will get T2 equal to T1 into T3 root over. So 1600 into 400 root over, you will get 800 Kelvin. Is the answer. The gas in cooling chamber of a closed cycle gas turbine. Closed cycle gas turbine. So PV diagram. In PV diagram, isentropic process, then constant pressure process or isobaric process. Here heat supplied QS, heat rejected QR. Constant pressure, heat supplied, and constant pressure, heat rejection. In TS diagram, constant pressure process, two constant pressure process and two isentropic process. 1, 2 isentropic, 2 to 3 constant pressure. Here also it's constant pressure. Clockwise cycle, heat supplied, heat rejected. So here cooling chamber, cooling is 4 to 1 heat rejection. So it's constant pressure process. Question is, an open cycle gas turbine works on open cycle gas turbine. Schematic diagram. Here this is compressor. This side turbine. From compressor it will go to heat exchanger. Then here to atmosphere, here from atmosphere, the working fluid or fresh air, fresh air, here exhaust gas, see turbine or prime mover, here compressor. Same shaft connection. Here this is heat exchanger. Heat is coming and out, in and out. This is open cycle gas turbine, works on Joule cycle. In a vapor compression system, the condition of refrigerant before passing through the condenser is what? VCRS, vapor compression refrigeration system. pH diagram I will draw. Pressure versus enthalpy. So it will come like this. One to two compression. Here 1 to 2 compression. Then condensation. 1, 2 to 3 condenser. 1 to 2 compressor. 3 to 4 isoenthalpic process. 4 to 1. Evaporator. So here condition of refrigerant before passing through the condenser, before 2 to 3, here at 2 point, what is its condition? It's superheated vapor. D is the answer. Here this side superheated. Here this line right side, this line represents saturated vapor line. Here this line represents saturated liquid line. And right side it's superheated region. Here this side it's left side it's liquid region. So in this case they asked at two condition, at point two what is its refrigerant's condition. Its condition is superheated vapor. D is the answer. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.